I mean, because a set of golf clubs costs a lot more money, and, you know, maybe they charge you 50 or 70 bucks or whatever it is to rent them. But if this costs 100 and, what was it, 129, did you say?
Yeah, 129. Yeah.
So if they buy them, and I'm sure they buy them at a wholesale price if they get some quantity, they can make that money back and then start making some good cash quick, huh?
Yeah, just a couple of rounds, and they're break even.
Awesome.
So that's the difference. The courses that have really, you know, sort of taken the bull by the horns and marketed it themselves and reached out to their community, told golfers, hey, next time you come in, bring your kids out to play, and we'll give them a fling stick. That gets the kids out on the course, gets the golfer out on the course again. Those are the ones that are really, you know, really making a good revenue on it. And the other courses, they're just great. They just let people come and play, and they collect that extra revenue without putting a lot of effort into it.
Well, if any folks are listening and they want to get their own fling stick, they can go to your website, flinggolf.com. And, of course, if any golf courses are listening and they would like to speak with you about making sure that they are fling friendly, then they should probably go to flinggolf.com as well, and they can find they could reach out to you then, right?
That's right. That's the way to do it.
Well, it's a lot of fun, and the industry needs fun things to keep the interest going, especially amongst the young generation. So thanks to you, Alex, for inventing this.
All right. Well, thanks a lot, Dan. I appreciate it.
My pleasure. All right. What we're going to do is we are going to take a quick break, and then we will be back with some travel news and some travel deals. You don't want to miss it. So we'll be back with more of the Golf and Travel Show. Stay tuned.
Cinderella story out of nowhere. A former grangekeeper now about to become the Masters champion.
It looks like I'm a wreck. It's in the hole!
I rap fly, call me Chocolate Thunder, and I got good to go, 4 strokes under, get out the way, if you wanna go play, cause I give it my all, every single day.
Have a lot of cash, cause I sink my putts, stacks and stacks, cause I'm making the cuts.
And we are back, and if your business needs industrial workers, or if you're looking for work, you gotta call Labor Finders. Labor Finders places for temporary or temporary to hire opportunities. For skilled, semi-skilled, or general labor positions such as plumbers, electricians, concrete workers, forklift operators, hospitality, office clerical, and much, much more. Labor Finders has almost 200 offices nationwide. Near here in Boca Raton, they have offices in Homestead, Miami, Fort Lauderdale, West Palm Beach, and in Jupiter. So if you need legal, insured workers, or if you're looking for work, call Labor Finders toll-free at 800-864-7749. That's 800-864-7749, or visit laborfinders.com.
I'm gonna wake you up early, cause I'm gonna take a ride with you. We're going down to the Honda shop, I'll tell you what we're gonna do. Put on a ragged sweatshirt, I'll take you anywhere you want me to.
And we are back, and remember, the HondaClassic.com. Go get some tickets, go check out the best players in the world, and support some of some really important charities right here in your local community, and see some incredible golf. I highly recommend it. Great venue, PGA National Resort. Go check it out. Speaking about a great venue, here's a venue that I visited many, many years ago. Had an opportunity to stay at Callaway Gardens in Georgia. Beautiful golf, and of course the gardens are just incredible. In the summer, they are the host to the FSU Student Circus, which is the coolest thing. When I went there, my kids were young. It was before my son even dreamt about going to FSU as a student, and the kids had an opportunity to learn to be in the circus, basically, and, you know, walk the high wire and stuff like that. It, you know, flying trapeze, you name it. It's just very, very cool. But they have a lot of events there to help support, keeping the gardens looking the way they do. And I gotta tell you, I mean, they are just stupendous. At Christmas time, driving through when it's all lit up is just incredible.
I like going when the weather's warmer so I could get some golf in. But they do have an event that's coming up that's pretty cool, and it is to raise money for the Ida Kaysen Callaway Foundation, which supports keeping it in bloom, so to speak. And I just thought this was really unique. It is an event called the Waffle House Showdown. And I have to tell you something. I am not one of those guys that is on the road and I seek out a Waffle House. There are people that love them. Not exactly my cup of tea. I like a waffle, but not a Waffle House. But this is a little bit different. They are going to have some famous chefs that are going to be creating dishes for you to sample with a Waffle House theme. So it's a little bit different. So I thought it was pretty cool. So this event is going to be going on from Thursday, March 15th through Sunday, March 18th. It's it's part of an ongoing event called Sip and Savor, or Spring Sips and Savor. So it's just this year that it happens to have this Waffle House theme. There'll be four renowned chefs from across the region that are facing off. And I just thought it was pretty cool. So if you're interested in going, let's see, sipandsavorspring.com, special website for this event. So go check that out and, you know, support these beautiful gardens. And if the weather is right, if I were you, I would be checking out the golf course there, too. I mean, just a great place to play golf. Another place that I talk about frequently, and I will be heading there in April. I usually go there 5 or 6 times a year, but this is a slow year for me. It may only be 3 or 4 times. I hope not. But there is a concert venue at the Hard Rock. We had mentioned the Hard Rock before. They call that the Joint. But this story is about a different joint. This is the kind that you buy in Las Vegas free, not free, but legally would be the word, whether you have a medical card or not. So that's, you know, the marijuana industry, the legal marijuana industry in Nevada. And in Las Vegas, it's big. And there was a story in the news today that at the airport now, they are setting up these green metal containers. And what they are is they're drop boxes, so that before you go through security and get yourself in trouble because the federal government does not recognize what's legal in the state of Nevada, you can drop it in there. So they started putting these around the airport and also at the rental center. They have one rental center there where all the car rental companies are all located together. They're being called amnesty boxes, which I thought was pretty cool. And they, I guess they outsourced it to some company that picks it up. So I don't know. That's just an interesting concept, if you ask me. So I just thought that it was pretty cool. I mean, times are changing. I think they have something similar in Colorado, in probably in Denver. I think I heard 2 different airports. My guess it would be in Denver and in Colorado Springs, perhaps. That they also have these amnesty boxes. But I don't know. I want to know who it is that has the job of picking all this stuff up and how they get paid. So I don't know. But I just thought that was pretty cool. Also, of course, every week I try and report on the airlines. And this week is no different. And I try and report fairly on the good, the bad, the ugly of all the airlines. Obviously, I've got my favorites, and more often than not, there are positive reports about my favorites. That's why they're my favorites. But they all have their ups and downs, and here's a story of something on a Southwest flight that just came out today. It's a story that occurred actually on Wednesday, and it seems that somebody's emotional support dog bit a young girl on the face. And the picture of the dog, it looked like a lovely dog, but for some reason, it just didn't work out too good. I don't think it was a very bad bite. I think it was a minor scrape, but the dog was asked to leave the flight with its owner, of course. And they didn't resist. I mean, obviously, everybody was upset about this, but it just added to the story that's going on now. The other day we reported about the peacock that somebody tried to take on, the emotional support peacock, and that didn't work, and that United is changing some of their policies on emotional support animals. And I think Delta decided that they also were going to make some changes with their emotional support animals, because what's happening is it's starting to have a negative effect on those surrounding on the flight. So I think nobody has a problem with somebody who truly is in need, but it seems that the numbers of animals has been multiplying rapidly, and the different kinds of animals have been multiplying rapidly, which in turn is causing more incidents. So Southwest is going to take another look at their policies and see if they can tighten them up perhaps a little bit. And I mean, I understand people need help, and animals provide incredible support for folks. At the Honda Classic today, I saw somebody who had definite physical ailments. You could see the way he walked, and a beautiful dog was helping him, well-trained animal. Unfortunately, when it comes to emotional support, sometimes you can't tell, and there certainly are people that have needs for assistance, so it would be terrible to make judgments, but there's a reason why so many of these pets are coming on planes now, and it may have reached a point where it's too much, so we may see that going back, pulled back a little bit. Another airline that we report on frequently that I have not had an opportunity to fly on, just because I just haven't had an opportunity, it's Norwegian Air, which they kind of burst onto the scene a couple of years ago, offering economy flights, real inexpensive flights, no frills, over to Europe. You know, some of them $79, $89 to Europe from the States here. Of course, you know, if you want to breathe the air, there's a fee, but and I'm exaggerating slightly. But they seem to have expanded dramatically, and they just kept adding more and more flights from more and more cities, and it seems that they're not doing quite as good as you might think. They just reported that in the year 2017 they had a net loss of $38.5 million, and the fourth quarter actually was the worst of it. I guess they were doing okay until the fourth quarter. They lost $118.5 million just in the fourth quarter alone. So they have been growing tremendously, but they've got some issues. So I'll be curious to see if they continue to offer more and more flights at these incredibly low prices, and what happens with Norwegian. I mean, it's good that they're out there. They keep the other airlines that do provide some of the frills, like, you know, a carry-on or a checked suitcase or things like that, or even meals. I mean, when you go to Europe, on most airlines, they kind of wine and dine you, even free alcohol. So it's really the exact opposite of all that. So I don't know. We'll have to see where this goes. All right. Speaking of airlines, there was a story in the news this week about airplane that's being developed in China, and it's a new supersonic kind of a plane, and it seems that you're going to be able to go from New York to London in as little as 3.5 hours, which is about 2.5 times faster than what it is currently. So this is going back to the old days of the SSTs and the supersonic flights, and I guess it's pretty cool. It seems that we are working on a similar plane here too. Both Boeing and Lockheed Martin are planning to build hypersonic aircraft as well, just like this one. And, it would be great. I hope it's more comfortable than the old supersonic planes that they had. And hopefully the prices will also be a little bit more reasonable. I know I couldn't fly on those flights. Just way very, very pricey. So we'll see how that works out. But as we get closer and as more news comes in, I will certainly keep you all up to date on that. Another mode of transportation for your vacation is cruise lines. And we report on that regularly as well, almost every week. And they, too, have some really good stories and some really good deals and some not so good deals and not so good stories. And it seems that Carnival, who, of course, is headquartered just down the road a piece in Miami, that on one of their recent cruises that I don't believe it left out of here. No, it was from sailing from Melbourne to New Caledonia last week. And a group of people that was on board it seemed got a little bit rowdy and some fights were breaking out. There were some threats, then there were some fights, and some of the other passengers were feeling quite threatened and unsafe, and they complained. And when all was said and done, they eventually threw this family of people out. The police came and they took them away. And but the other people on the cruise, of course, were very upset, and their good time for a portion of the cruise was ruined. They probably were hoping that they'd get some sort of a refund. And as a goodwill gesture, it seems that Carnival offered a 25% off coupon for their next trip, which doesn't sound very generous to me. And I don't think any of the folks on board who really had their vacation kind of ruined by this were feeling very warm and fuzzy about the way Carnival tried to make this up to them. I mean, let's face it, you pay a lot of money to go on a cruise and you use your vacation time, and then to feel bullied, unsafe, and have brawls break out in the middle of, this was in the nightclub, I think, where it broke out. A lot of young people, kids are on board. Parents were upset. Not a good look for Carnival. So let's hope that they, too, review some of their policies and see if they could tighten things up and make sure that it's a safe environment for everybody on their ships. All right, I think what we are going to do is take one final break, and then we will have what many of you are always waiting for, and that would be Dan's Deals on Travel. I got some good ones for you. You won't want to miss it. So stay tuned, and we'll be back with more of the Golf and Travel Show. Diddy from a band called Utopia. Many of you maybe remember them from, I don't know, maybe 30 years or so ago, back in the 70s and 80s, fronted by a fellow by the name of Todd Rundgren, one of rock and roll's geniuses, both as a performer as well as a producer and writer. And they just announced that they're going back on tour, back together after like 20 years of being away from each other. So it's one of the longest reunions in the making, so one of my favorite bands, and hopefully one of yours, too. Speaking of favorites, this is a hotel that I am vaguely familiar with in a city that I've visited on many occasions and enjoy visiting, but it's a very expensive city to go to. But one of my coworkers, Selena, has actually spent weeks and months at a time at this hotel, because at a previous job, she used to have a lot of business in San Francisco. And she kind of moved into this place on multiple occasions, and it was her go-to place. But even this place is typically pretty expensive, because San Francisco is pretty expensive. I found this deal on Travelzoo. It is a hotel called the Handlery Union Square Hotel, right in Union Square. So it's a great location. It's a very, very, very short walk to the subway. So the BART, so you could get around as well on public transportation. As a matter of fact, you could take the BART from the San Francisco airport and be a block or so away from this hotel, so you don't need to rent a car, which you don't want to pay to garage a car in a city like this. So it's very, very convenient. It's a nice place. But normally, you'd pay upwards of $250 or so a night. But right now, via Travelzoo, you can get this for as little as $139 a night, about half price. It also, if you do decide to rent a car, they will discount your daily parking fee by 50% as well. It's normally $56 a day. So with this discount on this deal, it's actually affordable to rent a car and drive it into the city if you choose to. They do have a heated outdoor pool that's open year-round, a small private sauna, two that's available by appointment, and some of the rooms do have views from balconies, which is kind of neat. So a deal like that in San Francisco is kind of hard to come by. So you can find that on Travelzoo, but you got to hurry. It expires on February 26th, so you don't have much time. As I said, we're going to try and send you a little bit further away than usual this week's show. So I got some deals, and here's one that it's something that I've been wanting to do. It's a little bit pricey and a little bit time consuming, so I'm not sure or not. But my plan this year was to attempt to take a European river cruise. I've taken the ocean cruises a few times. I have not taken a European river cruise yet. There are some ships that are better, some lines that are better, some that are, you know, so-so. You do have to beware also of the rising waters. I know a month or two ago there was some issues in Paris where the Seine was extremely high, and sometimes these ships can't get under the bridges if that happens. But just like an ocean cruise, a river cruise is a package deal that can be a very, very good value. You know, you've got the roof over your head as well as your mode of transportation. You do get all your meals and some of your drinks included, as well as a whole bunch of other stuff, and I'll mention them in a moment. But what's really cool about it also is as we were just talking about, when you go into a city, driving and having a car can be difficult and expensive. But these river cruises, they dock right in the middle of the cities, and many of them also have bikes on board that you can borrow, as well as a lot of tours that are included. This particular trip is on Viking. It includes your airfare from many different cities, and it also includes a $300 onboard credit. And what you will be getting is, first of all, this is on Viking, which is, maybe you've seen their commercials on TV. I have. They are one of the better cruise companies for river cruising in Europe. They recently actually expanded into ocean cruising, too. It's 7 nights in November of 2019, so it's a little bit down the road. It includes your round-trip airfare from 29 different cities, so pretty much you're going to be covered without an upcharge. The $300 credit transfers to and from the ship, guided tours in each city, wine and beer with lunch and dinner, free onboard Wi-Fi. You're not going to get that on your typical ocean cruise. All your air and cruise taxes are also included, and it starts for a getaway on the Rhine as little as $2,144, and that's from Amsterdam to Basel or reverse. You'll be seeing the Netherlands, Germany, France, and Switzerland. For about $100 more, you can be on the Danube, so that would be from Passau to Budapest or reverse, and you'll be seeing Germany, Austria, Slovakia, and Hungary. And for that same price, you can also go on the Danube from Budapest to Nuremberg or reverse, and you'll be seeing Hungary, Austria, and Germany. So for these kinds of prices, including airfare, including all the taxes, the food, the alcohol, the Wi-Fi, the meals, the $300 credit, flying from almost any place in the U.S., this is an incredible deal, one that I would really like to consider myself. You've got until March 7th to book this one, so a little bit of time, but I wouldn't waste too much time, because to be able to pick what you want might not be simple. All of this is for November 18th, but they have like weekly trips almost during the month of November of 2019. So it gives you plenty of time to plan for it. And I mean, that is a really a good deal when you stop and think what it would cost you to fly, pay for a hotel, pay for meals, pay for food, wine, taxes, transfers, etc. You can't beat that. All right, now here is a deal to a place that I recently went to and enjoyed immensely. As a matter of fact, I was talking about it just a few minutes ago, that I can't wait to have an opportunity to get back. And that would be the beautiful country and the most friendly country of Thailand. And this I also found on Travelzoo, so you could find it right there. And this is an upscale trip. So you'll be talking about staying at really nice places, which is cool, and going to a lot of neat places as well. It's an 11-night tour. This includes your flights. It's through Gate One Travel, and you will be visiting Bangkok, and you'll see Wat Pho, the oldest temple in the city, and the giant reclining Buddha. I saw that. It was incredible. That Buddha is huge. You will also go to Ayutthaya. If I'm saying that incorrect, I apologize. You'll see the residence of the kings and Bang Pa Inn Royal Palace. You'll go to Sukhothai, the former capital and the birthplace of the Thai nation. Maesay, known as the Golden Triangle, that's where Thailand, Myanmar, and Laos meet. And Chiang Mai, and see the most sacred temple in northern Thailand. So you're going to get to really see quite a bit of the country. It includes your international flights. It includes flights within Thailand, all your airport transfers, 11-night accommodations, breakfast every day, three lunches, four dinners, transportation in a private motor coach, hotel porterage, sightseeing and entrance fees, guide services, taxes, fees, all of that is $1,249. I mean, a few years ago, maybe even more recently, just airfare alone to Thailand alone would be $1,249. This is a remarkable deal. And like I say, this is upscale. They've got dates from April through May and October through May of 2019, all of that on sale. You do need to book this by March 2nd. And I got to tell you something, you'll be saving at least $1,800 over regular prices. And all of your incidentals, by the way, when you're in Thailand, things are inexpensive in Thailand. You can get a good massage at a reputable place for about, $30 or so. And at a hotel, it might be $80 or $100. Compare that to what you pay here in the States at a nice hotel. You're going to pay significantly more for everything. So this trip is just a tremendous value. My last deal that I have for you is a place I have not been to before, a place that I would like to go to. It's a little far away, and of course it's very expensive, and that's why I haven't been there yet. But have I got a deal for you or what? Let me tell you. On Fiji Airways, you can fly nonstop to Fiji. Now, that is a long way from here. And from San Francisco, as little as $899. From Honolulu, it's $899. And from Los Angeles, it's $999. So you got to get yourself there. But again, this is paradise. So if you would like to go to paradise and you've been putting it off, this is a huge savings. One of the top 25 destinations in the New York Times, 52 places to go in 2018, Fiji was voted. They also have, and by the way, this includes checked luggage, all your meals in flight, drinks, and entertainment. So you are not on an economy flight. The flights themselves are an event. So you'll be eating and drinking the whole way, and you'll be enjoying it. It includes all your taxes, all your surcharges. You can also fly to other places such as New Zealand, Australia, Tonga, and Samoa. They're also on sale. And you can get a free three-day stopover in Fiji. So if you'd like to spend just 3 days in Fiji and go to a place like New Zealand or Australia, that's on sale as well. Now, these prices are only good if you book it by February 28th, so there's not that much time to do it. But I got to tell you, you know, you might want to stop in Hawaii on the way, Fiji, and then New Zealand or Australia. Those are places that I have not had an opportunity to visit. By the way, the golf in New Zealand and Australia is quite good, too. So I'm not sure about Fiji, if they have any golf there. So don't quite know. But in any event, I would check that out. They have dates available from March 6th through November 14th. The savings is about $760 off of what other competitors are currently charging to get to Fiji. Go check that out. I want to remind everybody about a couple of things. First of all, of course, the Honda Classic. If you are listening to me live on Friday night, you still have an opportunity to go on Saturday and Sunday. Go to thehondaclassic.com for ticket information. Also want to remind everybody, if you would like to know about who our guests are going to be on a particular week, you can go to our Facebook page. That would be facebook.com, The Golf and Travel Show. Click like, and we will make sure that before each show, you know who our guests are going to be. And by the way, thanks to our guest from this week, Alex Van Allen, the founder and CEO of Fling Golf. It's a lot of fun. You're going to want to check out Fling Golf. And of course, you can go to flinggolf.com for more information. We'll be back next week with another golf and travel show. Make sure you tune in.
On a tour of one-night stands, my suitcase and guitar in hand, and every stop is neatly planned for a poet and a one-man band. Homeward bound.
You have been listening to the Golf and Travel Show, hosted by Dan Chu. Heard live every Friday, 7 to 8 p.m. on 1470 WWNN, and replayed every Sunday from 6 to 7 p.m. on 740 AM WSBR. Visit the show on Facebook and tune in next week. If you are in South Florida or traveling the world, hit them straight. The opinions expressed on the following sponsor program are strictly those of the host, guests, and callers, and not necessarily those of the station, its staff, management, or sponsors.